Hey everybody, welcome back. This video is about the radiosensitivity of different tissue types within the human body. Remember that radiosensitivity is the degree to which a cell, tissue, organ, or organism is susceptible to the damaging effects of radiation. In other words, if a tissue has a high radiosensitivity, that means it is more likely to experience the damaging effects of radiation, like cell death or cell mutation. For these highly sensitive tissues, it doesn't take as much radiation dose for them to be harmed. If a tissue has a low radiosensitivity, that means it is less likely to experience the damaging effects of radiation. For these less sensitive tissues, it takes a lot more radiation dose for them to be harmed. Understanding the radiosensitivity of tissue types is important because some tissues require more precautions than others. This is why X-ray operators wear thyroid shields, but not forehead shields. This is why it's common in CT imaging to use special breast shields, but not kneecap shields. Some cell types and tissue types are just more sensitive than others. Tissues in the human body have a wide range of radiosensitivity. For example, bone marrow is very radiosensitive, but bone itself, like the cortical bone, is not very radiosensitive at all. Blood cells are very sensitive to radiation, but nerve cells are not very radiosensitive. The gastrointestinal system, like the colon and stomach, is very radiosensitive, but the urinary system is not so sensitive. The radiosensitivity of tissue is determined in part by the law of Bergonie and Tribondeau, which says the most radiosensitive cells are immature, they're unspecialized, that means undifferentiated, and they have a high reproductive activity. That means they're rapidly dividing. An immature cell refers to one that is at the early stages of its life cycle. An unspecialized cell refers to one that is not yet formed into a certain tissue type. High reproductive activity refers to the rate at which the cell is dividing and multiplying. We'll use red blood cells called erythrocytes as an example. A red blood cell goes through several stages of development before it actually becomes a red blood cell in circulation in the blood. They start as proerythroblast, then they become erythroblast, then normoblast. Next, they mature into reticulocytes, which may enter blood circulation, and finally, they become an erythrocyte, a fully mature red blood cell. Notice that proerythroblast, erythroblast, and normoblast all have the suffix blast in the name. The suffix blast refers to cells that are immature and still in development. They are not fully specialized, and they are rapidly dividing and multiplying. These immature blood cells are all very radiosensitive. That is, they're very prone to death and mutation from radiation exposure. These cells all exist in the bone marrow, which is why marrow is considered very radiosensitive. Also notice that reticulocytes and erythrocytes both have the suffix cyte in the name. The suffix cyte refers to cells that are mature and fully developed. They are specialized and not rapidly dividing and multiplying. These mature blood cells are not as radiosensitive. In other words, they're not as prone to death and mutation from radiation exposure. They're more sensitive than some cells, but less sensitive compared to immature blood cells. The specific radiosensitivity of certain tissue types in the human body are well understood. Some tissues with the highest radiosensitivity are the bone marrow, breast, lungs, colon, and stomach. These tissues are most likely to experience the damaging effects of radiation, like cell death or cell mutation. It doesn't take as much radiation dose for these tissues to be harmed. These tissues have the highest concentration of immature, unspecialized, rapidly dividing cells. Some tissues with moderate radiosensitivity are the gonads, liver, and thyroid. And finally, some tissues with the lowest radiosensitivity are the brain, the kidneys, and muscle tissue. These tissues are the least likely to experience the damaging effects of radiation, like cell death or cell mutation. In other words, it takes much higher radiation dose for these tissue types to be harmed. These tissues have the lowest concentration of immature, unspecialized, rapidly dividing cells. Most tissues in the body have been assigned a tissue weighting factor, or WT, that corresponds to their relative radiosensitivity. Bone marrow, breast, lungs, colon, and stomach all have a tissue weighting factor of 0.12. The gonads have a tissue weighting factor of 0.08. The liver and thyroid have a tissue weighting factor of 0.04, and the brain has a tissue weighting factor of just 0.01. Please be aware that these numbers can vary based on the publication or organization being referenced. These values come from the most recent values published by the International Commission on Radiological Protection. Differences in tissue radiosensitivity are important when calculating the effective dose. This is the dose value needed to assess stochastic effects, especially radiation-induced carcinogenesis. The effective dose is equal to the equivalent dose multiplied by WT. That's the tissue weighting factor. So here's a scenario. Let's say we have two different radiological procedures, both resulting in an equivalent dose of 10 millisieverts to different parts of the body, the brain, and then to the breast. An equivalent dose of 10 millisieverts to the brain equals an effective dose of 10 millisieverts multiplied by 0.01, that's a tissue weighting factor for the brain, which equals 0.1 millisieverts. The same 10 millisievert equivalent dose to the breast equals an effective dose of 10 millisieverts multiplied by 0.12, that's the tissue weighting factor for the breast, which equals 1.2 millisieverts. So it's the same equivalent dose, but a different tissue weighting factor results in a different effective dose and a different risk of cancer. This is because the breasts are more sensitive to radiation than the brain. Here's another way of looking at it. If the entire body was exposed to the same dose of radiation, the tissues most likely to develop cancer would be those with the highest radiosensitivity, which is represented by having a high tissue weighting factor. That would include the bone marrow, the breast, the lungs, the colon, and the stomach, which all have a tissue weighting factor of 0.12. Ready for a practice question? Which of these tissues is least sensitive to radiation? Pause the video and see if you can answer this question on your own. The correct answer is B, the brain. The brain is composed of nerve tissue, and nerve tissue is not very radiosensitive at all. These cells are mature, highly specialized, and not very active in reproduction. As a result, the brain and all nerve tissue is not very radiosensitive. In summary, a tissue with a high radiosensitivity is more likely to experience the damaging effects of radiation, like cell death or cell mutation. For these highly sensitive tissues, it doesn't take as much radiation dose for them to be harmed. The most sensitive tissues in the human body are the bone marrow, the breast, the lungs, the colon, and the stomach. A tissue with a low radiosensitivity is less likely to experience the damaging effects of radiation. For these tissues, it takes a lot more radiation dose for them to be harmed.
If you enjoyed this video, I encourage you to visit cloverlearning.com and explore our robust selection of video-based courses, certification exam prep question banks, and continuing education resources. Lastly, please remember to hit the like button, subscribe, and turn on notifications so you can stay up to date on our latest videos.